Hello, my dear students. Very good morning to all of you. Once again, I welcome you all to this TYBSC online lecture. In the last lecture, we discussed about conversion, selectivity, and yield of a chemical reaction. In this lecture, we are going to discuss some new concept of modern approach to chemical industry. Let's see. So these are the points to discuss today in this lecture. That is very important points: intellectual property and the rights, importance of intellectual property rights, types of intellectual properties. So in this lecture, we are going to see the basic idea of intellectual property and intellectual property rights. So first of all, we have to understand what is meant by intellectual property. This is a very important unit which are based in any organization or any industry for any product or any the product of a chemical industry or working in a chemical industry. For any organization, intellectual property is very important. With that, new innovations, new creations are made, and further those innovations, those creations are developed with a different research and development. So first of all, we have to understand what is meant by intellectual property. Intellectual property is a creation of human mind. Anything which is created by the human mind, whether the creation by a person or a group of a person. For example, the any invention relating to the product or a process or any new design of an article or literacy work, artistic work, trademark, patent, or some of the times symbols of the company, logo of a company, everything which are created by the human mind is known as the intellectual property. Here we can see some examples. The name of Patanjali, the Amazon, the Amul, the Taste of India, the logo of Hyundai, as well as the Google homepage, which are the creation of a human mind, which is intellectual property. Intellectual property, which is a intangible property, which is not a physical property. As we know, the car, land, home, everything, those are the tangible property. Here intellectual property, which is a human creation of a mind, which is an intellectual property. Intellectual property rights. Here, this intellectual property right is the statutory right granted by the government to the applicant or owner of an intellectual property to exclude others from exploiting the IP commercially for a given period of a time. IP laws vary from nation to nation. In international level, the IP, that is intellectual property, managed by the World Intellectual Property Organization. Here we have to understand, once there is a creation of a human mind, which is anything, whether it is the artistic work, whether it is literacy work, or whether it is any design, whether it is any innovations which is made by the human creation, those are protected under the statutory right. That is nothing but the intellectual property right. Now, why we need the IPR? Here, basically, the IP can be protected for our IPR establish legal and valid ownership about an intellectual property. Suppose a organization is created some new things, those are protected by the intellectual property rights. Here it is, it gives a statutory protection by the government. IP can be used to establish goodwill and brand value in the market. IP owner can sell or license the IP for a commercial gains. Here, the inventor or a creator or an author of an IP can mention about the IP in or his resumes for show their competence. Okay. Now, let me see, move towards the types of intellectual property. Basically, the intellectual properties are classified into two categories, and one more of that is soft IP is there. That is, they are categorized into copyright, industrial property, and soft IP. Here, the copyright includes literary work and the artistic work. Industrial property includes patents, trademark, industrial designs, and geographical indications. The soft IP includes secrets of confidentiality of a company or organization. Let's see one by one. Copyright, it includes literary work or artistic work. Literary work, it includes novels, poems, plays, films, and musical work, etc., etc. It means for an organization, for a product, for a company, if you are creating some of the poems or music or some slogans, everything, they are under the literary work. Sometimes the company, it includes some drawings, paintings, photographs are the artistic work. Here we can see the example of Tom and Jerry is an example of a copyright, which is a artistic work. So likewise, for the development of a product, we can certain things of music, poems, plays are under the literary work, or drawing, paintings, photographs of different architectural designs are under the artistic work. Basically, the Indian Copyright Act of 1957 governs the system of copyrights in India, which are amended in 1982, 1984, 1992, 1994, and further in 1999. It is a right which grants protection to authorship of original creative work, whether the copyright, it includes the proper right to the author of original creative work. Duration of a copyright protection is author's lifetime plus 60 years of author's death. Copyright protection is always expires on December 31st of the last of the calendar. Okay, so here these are the copyrights are included artistic work and literary work. Let me move towards the patent, which is an industrial property. Patent describes the new invention right. Patent law in India governed by the Patent Act of 1970. Further, this Patent Act of which was amended in 2005, that is Patent Amendment Act 2005. Patent law deals with an inventor's exclusive right to use their own invention. It is a right that empowers patentee to prevent or stop the use of his or her invention by third parties without his or her permission. So, patent, here is nothing but patent, it is related to the invention. The invention in general means any new creation or idea relating to a product, machine, process capable of industrial application can be patented. So, an invention according to the Indian Patent Act means it may be a new product or a new process involving an inventive step, and it must have the capable of industrial applications. Those are any creation, any new idea undertaken by the patent. Next is trademark. Trademark is a distinctive sign or indication used by the individuals or business organization. Here we can see the logos or some names, trade names, some designs, word, color, and other combinations are under the trademark. Indian trademark is protected under the Trademark Act of 1999. This is very important. Where the Trademark Act is protected? Under section of 2ZB Act defines the trademark. Here, the trademark can be any name, symbol, logo or slogan, word of a organization. Here we can see the Amul, the Taste of India, which is a trademark, or LIC, we can see Jintavi ke Saath bhi, Jintavi ke Baad bhi, which is a slogan of LIC, which is a trademark relating to the organization. Here we can see different symbols are used in the trademark. TM for promoting the goods or products, SM to promote the services, and R we can see here registered mark. Here the trademark, we can see name, logo type, symbol, slogan, shape, color, everything which are included in the trademark. TM valid for 10 years and can be renewed. SM valid for 17 years and it can be renewed. Further, industrial design. An industrial design constitutes a ornamental or a beauty aspects of an article. It includes three-dimensional shape or a features of a product. Here we can see any product which have a designs, industrial designs means organization or a company of a product, it can be have its own designs. It includes two-dimensional features, patterns, lines or color of the product. Here we can see the images. There are different cold drink bottles are there. Each company has its own shape of a bottle, and for that convenience, for understanding, here we can see the two different switches. One is the company of Ligrant and one is the Anchor. The shape of the both companies, they are the different, because those are protected under the Industrial Design Act. Geographical indication. This is very important again. Geographical indication means the indication of a goods or originating, produced, processed or prepared in a specific geographical area or territory of a country where a given quality, reputation or other characteristics of such goods are essentially attributable to its geographical origin. Here geographical indication, which is nothing but the any goods or a product which are basically produced from a specific area or geographical conditions, those get the GI tags. Here geographical indications or GI tag, it provides particular indication of that area who are involved from producing a unique product from that area. It helps purchaser or users of the goods to identify the goods manufactured or produced in a particular geographical area. Now here we can see the example. Darjeeling tea, which is a product of a Darjeeling, which is obtained the GI tag. Kullu shawl, which is a shawl from the Kullu area. Kolhapuri chappal, we can say the chappals which are basically manufactured, produced from the Kolhapuri, they get the GI tags. Here Mahabaleshwar strawberry, whenever you visit the Mahabaleshwar, definitely we purchase some strawberries which are obtained the GI tags, means where the location of the product which are to be originated. Bengali rasagulla, we can see here, whenever the Bengali rasagulla, means the rasagulla basically from Bengal, which is obtained the GI tag. And finally you can see the both, there are lot of examples are there. Here for our convenience, here I put some of the examples. Mysore sandal soap, sandal soap which is produced from the Mysore area. Likewise, the products obtained from the GI tag which are related, originated from that geography area. These are the some IP rights in India. Here we can see IP rights are protected in accordance with the provisions of the corresponding legislation of a country. In India, IPR can be protected and monopolized under the provisions of different acts, such as the Patent Act of 1970, the Design Act of 2000, the Trademark Act 1999, the Geographical Indications of Goods Act 1999, the Copyright Act of 1957, the Integrated Circuit Layout and Design Act of 2000, the Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers Right Act of 2001. So with this, I will conclude here. An intellectual property which we have studied, that is refers to creation of a human mind. Intellectual property right, which gives us the legal protection to that organization or a company which are created by the humans or organization. IP law mainly categorized into two ways, we already studied, copyright and industrial property. and also we studied the Indian IP rights and acts which are related to it in India. So with this, I hope you are understood the what is mean by IP and what is mean by IPR. IP is nothing but the human creation of a mind. IPR, which is the right, it gives the legal protection, and the types which we are seen, there are copyright and industrial properties. Copyrights which are artistic work and the literary work, industrial property of patent, trademark, industrial designs, and geographical indications. Okay, so with this, I hope you are all are understood, and with this lecture also this topic is over. Once again, thank you so much for watching this lecture.